Hi, my name is Ronnie Watta, and today we're going to talk about the siege of Ranthambore on Let's Talk About Bharat. In 1299, Alauddin Khilji sent his generals Nusrat Khan and Uluk Khan to capture Gujarat. When the army was returning to Delhi after its successful campaign, some of the Mongols staged a mutiny against the generals near Jalore. The mutiny was crushed, but two rebel Mongol leaders, Muhammad Shah and Kabru, managed to escape with some of their followers. Hammir Dev Chauhan, king of Ranthambore, granted asylum to these Mongol fugitives. Now, Uluk Khan sent messengers to Hammir urging him to kill the Mongol fugitives as a friendly ruler. He also threatened to wage a war against Hammir if this request was not complied with. But Hammir refused to do so and replied to Uluk Khan that he had no desire to start a conflict, but he would not give up the refugees who had sought his asylum. According to the Hammir Mahakavya, Alauddin dispatched a large army of 100,000 strong to conquer Ranthambore. At a mountain pass called Hinduvata, the Chauhan army inflicted a heavy defeat on the Delhi forces. This army was led by Hammir's own generals as well as the Mongol leaders who had taken asylum at Ranthambore. Hammir's own generals included his brother Virama, Ratipala, Jaja and Rana Malla. The Mongol leaders included Muhammad Shah, his brother Garbhuraka, Tichara and Vaichara. The Chauhan army captured much of the Delhi army's equipment as a result of this victory. After the defeat, Alauddin asked Nusrat Khan, the governor of Awadh, to lead an army in Uluk Khan's support. Finally, the Delhi army reached Ranthambore and encamped near the fort walls. A messenger from Alauddin offered two alternatives to Hammir. Present 400,000 mohurs, four elephants and Hammir's daughter in marriage to Alauddin. Second, surrender the Mongol rebels who had taken refuge at Ranthambore. Hammir scornfully rejected the demands and replied that Alauddin could have 400,000 sword wounds instead. The Delhi army then besieged the fort and tried to scale its walls, but Nusrat Khan was hit by a manjanik stone and died after 2 to 3 days. Taking advantage of the mourning in the invaders' camp, Hammir came out of the fort with a strong army and forced Uluk Khan to retreat to Jam. When Alauddin learned about Uluk Khan's defeat, he decided to personally lead a stronger force to Ranthambore. He ordered his other officers from various provinces to bring their armies to Tilpat near Delhi. After reaching, Alauddin realized that a direct attack on the fort was not feasible as the advantage lay with the defenders. Alauddin's army tried to construct a tunnel, but the defenders destroyed it and killed those involved in its construction by throwing a mixture of oil and resin on them. But after a long siege, the defenders suffered from famine and defections. Hammir's generals Ratipala and Rana Malla led their forces out of the fort and joined Alauddin's army. Hammir realized that Alauddin would capture the fort sooner or later, so he decided to fight to death with his loyal men while the ladies of the fort prepared for suicide by Johar. Hammir and his loyal companions fought to death with Alauddin's army. Some Rajputera bards claim that Hammir severed his own head and offered it to the god Mahadeva when faced with a certain death. According to the 16th century historian Firishta, Alauddin's army captured the fort on 10 July 1301. And before returning to Delhi, Alauddin gave the control of the fort to Uluk Khan. I hope you like this video about the siege of Ranthambore. Smash a like if you did, share it with your friends and family, and keep watching Let's Talk About Bharat.